Shalom and good evening. This is TV7 Israel News broadcasting to you from Jerusalem. And in today's top stories, Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu reiterates Israel's commitment to expanding the circle of peace, stressing that while regional leaders have accepted Israel's legitimacy, the main obstacle to realizing peace is a deep, distorted, and misled representation of Israel in public opinion on the Arab streets. President Mahmoud Abbas instructs Palestinian representatives in Washington to suspend contact with their American counterparts, that after the Trump administration warned Ramallah that unless they enter into serious peace negotiations with Israel, the United States will have no other choice but to close the Palestinian mission in Washington. Russian President Vladimir Putin holds conversations with international leaders, including President Trump and Prime Minister Netanyahu, seeking an international consensus around a peace deal for Syria. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu, in a special Knesset session marking 40 years to late Egyptian President Anwar Sadat's visit to Israel's parliament, declared that since the historic visit, peace with Egypt has traversed all the pitfalls, maintaining an open channel of communication between Jerusalem and Cairo that is vital to the security of both countries. The Israeli leader further emphasized that today, amid clear regional challenges, many countries that perceived Israel as an obstacle to regional stability have come to realize that the Jewish state is the moderate, responsible, and tough actor that has become a key contributor in the battle against radical and violent Islam.
Today, 4 years after the visit of Sadat in the country, חלקים נרחבים מן העולם הערבים מבינים היטב לא רק את מה שהתרחש פה לפני 40 שנה, הם מבינים היטב את מה שיכול להתרחש פה בזכות השינויים שמתרחשים באזור. מדינות רבות יודעות שהאיום על המזרח התיכון אינו נובע מישראל, אלא להפך. ישראל היא הגורם המתון, האחראי וגם התקיף שנאבק יחד איתן באיום זה. האיום הגדול על האזור נובע מהאסלאם הקיצוני והאלים שמונהג על ידי איראן מצד אחד ועל ידי דאעש מצד שני. האסלאם הקיצוני שרומס באכזריות כל מה שנמצא בדרכו.
Prime Minister Netanyahu took the opportunity to reiterate Israel's commitment to expanding the circle of peace, stressing that while regional leaders have accepted Israel's legitimacy, the main obstacle to realizing peace is a deep, distorted, and misled presentation of Israel on the Arab streets, that after years of propaganda against the Jewish state and its people.
אנחנו מחויבים להרחבת מעגל השלום למדינות אחרות וגם לשכננו הפלסטינים. אני יודע שגם הנשיא טראמפ וצוותו מחויבים ליעד זה. המכשול הגדול ביותר להרחבת השלום היום איננו מצוי במנהיגים של המדינות מסביבנו. המכשול הוא דעת הקהל ברחוב הערבי, דעת קהל שנשטפה במשך שנים על ידי הצגה מוטעת ומוטעת של מדינת ישראל.
That said, Netanyahu pointed to certain meager changes in the Arab world's public opinion toward Israel, stressing the importance of encouraging this change by combating what he termed as a historic propaganda wall of deception. In other news, Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas concluded a visit to the Spanish capital, Madrid, during which the Palestinian leader met with Spain's King Felipe VI, as well as with Prime Minister Mariano Rajoy and other Spanish officials. During an official state luncheon with the Spanish monarch Felipe, President Abbas accused Israel of attempting to change the identity and nature of Jerusalem, while declaring that the Palestinian leadership remains committed to peace based on international resolutions and principles which aim at realizing a two-state solution. In response to President Abbas's accusation of Israel's attempts to so-called Judaize Jerusalem, a senior Israeli official told TV7 that the unfounded Palestinian narrative is part of their ongoing propaganda against the Jewish state. The official further asserted that the Palestinians seek to fuel an ignorant bias against Israel, attempting to distort facts that are clearly and definitively portrayed in the Bible. Meanwhile, in what Palestinian sources told TV7 was a pre-calculated decision, President Mahmoud Abbas instructed Palestinian representatives in Washington to suspend contact with their American counterparts, that after the Trump administration put the Palestinian leadership on notice, warning Ramallah that unless they enter into serious peace negotiations with Israel, the United States will have no other choice but to close the Palestinian mission in Washington. The apparent threat by Washington came after U.S. Secretary of State Rex Tillerson has determined that the Palestinians breached an obscure provision of an American law that explicitly demands the closing of the Palestine Liberation Organization's mission if the Palestinians would attempt to prosecute Israeli officials for alleged crimes against Palestinians at the International Criminal Court in The Hague. The Palestinian president's spokesman, Nabil Abu Odeyna, confirmed Abbas's decision, yet stressed that the directive instructed only low-level personnel to suspend contact with their American counterparts, emphasizing that the Palestinian relations with the United States administration and President Donald Trump remain excellent. Now, in other news, Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu held a phone conversation last night with Russian President Vladimir Putin. According to the Prime Minister's office, the conversation lasted about an hour and a half, during which the two leaders discussed various regional challenges, primarily the situation in Syria and Iran's ongoing military entrenchment across the war-torn country. The phone conversation came after a surprise meeting between President Vladimir Putin and his Syrian counterpart Bashar Assad in the Russian resort city of Sochi. During their meeting, the Syrian president thanked his Russian counterpart for Moscow's dedicated support, which he emphasized saved Syria as a state. The two leaders further discussed the future of Syria, particularly an implementation of a political process that would grant stability to the war-torn country.
Самый главный вопрос, конечно, это вопрос последующего, после разгрома террористов, мирного политического урегулирования, долгосрочного урегулирования ситуации в Сирии. Я очень хотел бы обсудить с вами основные принципы организации политического процесса, проведения поддержанного вами Конгресса народов Сирии. Очень бы хотелось услышать ваши оценки сегодняшнего состояния и перспектив развития ситуации, в том числе и ваше видение политического процесса, который, как нам представляется, безусловно, в конечном итоге должен осуществляться под эгидой Организации Объединенных Наций. И в ходе самого процесса мы рассчитываем на активное участие ООН.
Russia is actively trying to build an international consensus around a peace deal for Syria. The declared focus of Russia's peace efforts is a proposed Congress of Syrian peoples to include all the country's ethnic groups and the warring sides in the conflict. Damascus, however, is wary of foreign intervention in its domestic affairs, urging Moscow to thwart international efforts to influence any political outcome to a final solution for Syria. Following their meeting and ahead of a trilateral meeting between President Putin and his Turkish and Iranian counterparts Recep Tayyip Erdogan and Hassan Rouhani, the Russian leader held a phone conversation with President Donald Trump to update him on the latest developments pertaining to the Syria conflict. The White House released a statement saying the conversation, which lasted about an hour and a half, focused on the importance of bringing about a viable solution to Syria, which would be acceptable for both Washington and Moscow. Thank you for watching us. Praying for the peace of Israel and the peace of Jerusalem. I'm Jonathan Hassan, have a Erev Tov, and we will see you again tomorrow at the same time.
In order to donate to TV7 Israel News, please follow these simple steps. first press the donate logo, located at the bottom left side of TV7 Israel News Facebook page, or on the donate tab at the head of the page. Then insert the amount you'd like to donate, and fill in your credit card information. Just like this. And press Review Donation and Continue. After reviewing your donation details, please press Donate to finalize your donation. That's it! Your donation is now complete, and an email with your donation details has been sent to your email address. You can also print your donation receipt by pressing the link here. Thank you for supporting TV7 Israel News.